Hi friends, in our previous sessions we have learned how to find the perimeter of quadrilaterals. If you haven't watched it yet, you can watch it after this session. For now, let's move further. Now we'll go inside the boundaries and find the area. We'll try to simplify it by using triangles. Let's proceed. Guys, we know that any quadrilateral diagonally can be divided into two triangles, right? And the area of a triangle is half times base into height. But some of our friends get confused about the height of the triangles. For example, in this triangle, we say the height is AB, but this is not true. The height is always a perpendicular height, not slant. Here AB is slanted. But if the triangle is a right angle triangle, in this case only AB is the perpendicular distance, that is height of the triangle. Triangles play a very important role in finding and formulating the areas of quadrilaterals. Seems strange, right? Something which is rarely seen. Let's see how it works. We'll be finding areas of all types of quadrilaterals by only using the area of a triangle. So what do we have to keep in mind? Half times base into height. Let's again start with our first family, the parallelogram family. There are four members in parallelogram family. We have to follow these three steps. The first step is divide all of them into two triangles. Then add the areas of these two triangles. And the final step is arrange them and derive the formula. First of all, we'll find the areas of parallelogram and rhombus, and then we'll go for the rectangle and square. Let's name them as ABCD. Now, when we cut them, we get two congruent triangles. So here triangle ABC and triangle ADC are congruent. If we double the area of triangle ADC, it will give us total area of parallelogram ABCD. And the procedure will be same for rhombus. Now you tell me, what is the area of triangle ADC? For that, we need height. So let's consider H is perpendicular height, so that area of triangle ADC is half times DC into H, where DC is the base. Now double it up to get the area of parallelogram. So after doubling, we get DC into H. In general, we can say area of parallelogram is base into height, where DC is base and H is representing the height. For rhombus as well, we'll get the same formula. In fact, area of all members of this family can be found by using the same formula, because every member of this family can be divided into two congruent triangles. So area of all member will be base into height. The only difference is, in rectangle and square, we get two congruent right angle triangles. So height is AD or BC. So we say that area of rectangle is length into breadth, and that for a square, it is calculated as side into side, that is side square, because its all sides are equal. But the core idea behind all of this is base into height. By this, we are done with the parallelogram family, and I hope you all find it simple and interesting. Let's try to find the area of the trapezium family with the same logic on our own. Follow the first step. Divide all the types of it into two triangles. But here, we will find the area of both the triangles respectively, because these triangles are not congruent, unlike parallelogram. Okay. Second step, now consider parallel sides of it as base for both respective triangles, so that height will be same for both the triangles, because they are drawn in parallel line segments. Right? Okay. Third step, add the areas of these two triangles. So we'll get area of trapezium ABCD equals half times CD into H, where H is the height, plus half times AB into H. Now we can take half and height common. So we'll get half times addition of parallel sides into the height. Right? So this becomes the formula to calculate area of any kind of trapezium. Isn't it easy and seems meaningful now? Can you do it for a kite? Let's do it together. We can divide a kite into two triangles in two different ways. Let's see first what happens if we divide it horizontally. First step, that is division, is done. Now there are two triangles, triangle ABD and triangle BCD. So we'll find area of these two triangles respectively. So area of kite ABCD is area of triangle ABD and area of triangle BCD. Area of triangle ABD is half times BD into H1, where BD is base and H1 is height for triangle ABD. Now similarly, for triangle BCD, it will be half times, again BD is the base and here height will be H2. Height for these two triangles are unequal. Therefore, we have taken the notations as H1 and H2. So we can take half and the base outside of the bracket. So we will get half times BD into H1 plus H2. Now what is H1 plus H2? Addition of these two heights become the diagonal of the kite. So here BD is the first diagonal and H1 plus H2 is AC, which is the second diagonal. So we say that area of a kite is half times multiplication of its diagonals, or half times product of its diagonals. Let's follow the same step if we cut a kite vertically and see whether we get the same formula or not. This is a homework for you. Try it. I'm sure you will get the same formula. By now, you need not to remember any formula. Just divide them into two triangles and find the area by using half times base into height. Friends, let me tell you an important thing, that area of parallelogram can also be found by using the formula of trapezium. Now you might be thinking, can we find the area of trapezium by using formula of parallelogram? No, this will not work. One more thing must have come in your mind, that if rhombus and square also belong to kite family, so can we use kite's formula to find the area of rhombus and square? If you haven't thought it yet, then think and write your opinion in the comment box as yes or no. Friends, don't try to simply mug up things without understanding it. Math is not a problem. It is a tool to simplify things and makes everything easy and convenient. Let's see what we learn in today's session. So, this is it for today. Write your queries and difficulties in the comment box and subscribe to Let's Tute. Keep watching, keep learning. Thank you.